Hello everyone, welcome back to another coding adventure. I'm going to continue right where I left off from the previous video. It's actually exporting out of my software into the video format in the background. I hope that it doesn't actually interrupt us in the, I don't think it'll pop up, but all right. So at the end of the last video, we discovered that we need, or I discovered that I need a text editing controller in order to take the data from the contact that I pick with the picker and attach it to the fields. Now, my thinking is, section here. Well, I guess I can put it right under there. No, I should be its own section. Text field controllers. I'm going to make three controllers. I'm going to make a. Well, let's figure out how to do it. The controller is what actually m will change the state of the text field. Text editing controller. Okay, I don't have to say new. Okay, so text editing controller. The underscore means private in Dart because there's no actual modifiers. I don't know why it needs to be private, but I guess it just will be. So this will be name field controller. Let's do this again. Text editing controller. Phone field controller and a text editing controller for description field. It's hanging. Android Studio not responding. Oh, okay. Description field controller. All spelled correctly. Okay, good. Now, in the properties for each text field, we will set the controller to the name field controller. Let me just hot reload and see if that breaks anything. It shouldn't, because I'm not specifying any initial values to it. Oh, that reminds me. I need to. Yeah, I need to set. That's right, I need the init state. And I'll. Yeah, I'll give it an initial value of nothing on pressed. Then I can, I guess, set the controller. Can I? I guess there will be a controller.setText or something. Anyway, name field controller. It'll be empty text. Let's see if that breaks anything. Nothing. Good. And I'll do the same for the phone field controller and the description field controller. So those have been set up. And now, I guess my name field controller, is there a set? Dot selection. Notify all the new lists that it needs to update. For this reason, the so I guess selection is what it needs. New text selection. Oh, that's weird. Selection isn't a function. is funky. Oh. Previous video is done. Alright, that's cool. New value. Oh wait, new text. Bam. That's it. I don't know why I should have known that from up there. Because it has a text property. Oh no, I don't want it to be... Text isn't a function. I guess it's going to be... This is so weird. This sets the text. Oh, it's a property, right? I guess equals new dot text equals contact dot full name. Ah, that's it. Now hot reload. I'm gonna try picking the contact to see if it breaks. Oh, it broke. The setter text was called on null. Object, no such method. Well, that's strange. I mean, do I have to make a new text editing controller every time? Doesn't like this. The name field controller. You know, let me take a look at the example in the contact picker because it's set. Oh, it just set it to the whole. Yeah, that's not helpful. Has some initial value. Well, handle text changes. I don't think this uses a text editing controller. We give it the property. Listen for controller changes. Oh. Add listener. What is that? Add listener. Add start listening to changes. Oh, I haven't. Okay. But what is this? And this print latest value is a method. That's whenever the text changes. This is not really what I want. Well, all right, I'm gonna try and... All right. Yeah, I'm thinking about this as in terms of setting the text, but I guess I do need this dot add listener. Where do they do it? In the init state, okay. So, oh wait, yeah, dot add listener. It needs a listener. But what constitutes a listener? Let's check out the API. Register a closure to be called when the object changes. I guess it'll be contact.fullname. The argument stream can't be assigned to the parameter type void. Well, that doesn't make any sense. Try again. Just puts a listener in here. Add the listener. It's a void listener. Register a closure to be called when the object changes. The message must not be called after dispose of it. What is a listener, though? Void callback listener. Callbacks that have no argument and return no data. I don't really get it. Well, it's like a method. I don't know. Did get name. Undefined did get name. I don't know. I'll just see if that works. And then unchanged. Does the controller? Well, let me give it a shot. Minimize, please. Thank you. All right. I think this isn't going to work, but accidental app open, please close, thank you. Let's go to the logcat. The prints happen in the logcat. As opposed to the messages or the run. All right, I don't think that's exactly what I want to see. A resource failed to call close? I don't know what that means. Let's go to the logcat. Grab the contact. Well, it didn't crash. Funky. Didn't crash. So okay, so clearly adding the listener doesn't do anything. This is obviously not what I want. Actually, you know what? Let me try this again. Oh yeah, there was nothing. Search for second. What is that? second. Yeah. I'm fairly certain that this is not what I want. Well, in that case, why don't I just search for text editing controller up here, get the actual class. Selection, the currently selected text. Text is the current string the user is editing. Those are properties. Methods, clear, clear composing, listener, closure to be called. Yeah, I don't really know what that means. So imagine notify listeners, remove listeners, to string. I don't see any reason why I couldn't. I'm setting state, and I don't see any reason why the name field controller dot text. I don't know, what if I just set it to test as a text isn't a function, right? It has to equals test. I don't know why that would not work. It didn't work. I don't understand why. Maybe print name field controller dot toString. Up to the logcat, and it should say first name. Oh, something happened. Setter text was called on null. Yeah, it's tried calling text equals test object is no such method. This is mad. Oh, that was not what I wanted to do. This is mad weird. Yeah, there's that error again. Setter text was called on null. But I don't. Did I not set the controller? I thought I set the controller. Oh man, maybe I didn't actually. Oh. I did set the controller to name, that's on the text field. This is the button. Man, I don't understand. Maybe that'll do it. Still null. It thinks the name field controller is null. I don't understand that. I set it up. I set its state. It exists. I don't. I don't get it. I don't get it. I'm gonna give it some dummy value. See if that does anything. See, it's not. The controller is of the text field is set. Oh, you know what? Maybe because we're changing state, I have to do a full restart. I bet that's what the problem is. Wait. Why does it not like? Oh my gosh. Yes! That was it. That was it. I just had to do a full restart. Oh man. That's great. But maybe I can simplify this. Full restart. I completely forgot that. That when you set, when you mess with state, you have to do a full restart. That's it. Much simpler. Awesome. All right. Now I'm gonna get down in the phone field. I'm gonna give it a controller of phone field controller. And I'm gonna go back up here and text to the contact contact dot phone number. Oh, there we go. Oh, nope, not hot reload, not what I want. Full state, full restart. Incredible. But it has this modifier, this Is there any way that I could, that's like the contacts type, the numbers type. If is there any way that I could fix that? Back to the contact picker API. Because why would. Phone number. It has a number and a label. I understand what I have to do now. Dot label. Yeah, that'll do it. Wait, no, not the label. The number, s silly boy. Awesome. Very good. Very, very good. All right. Thanks for that. That'll do it for this video. Thanks for coming along on this coding journey with me. I'll see you guys in the next one.